Tong Hall has been a landmark in Hong Kong since the early 20th century. It was built in the Baroque Revival style, popular during that era. This three-story red brick mansion has an elliptical facade graced with granite columns and wrought iron verandahs. Situated in the mid-levels at No. 7 Lower Castle Road, it has the distinction of being the home of one of the first Chinese families allowed to live in the neighborhood. Completed in 1914, it was named after its owner, Mr. Ho Kum Tong. He lived there with his wife, children, and grandchildren. He was the younger brother of Sir Robert Hotung and Mr. Ho Fook. All three brothers were compradors for Jardine, philanthropists, and prominent members of the Chinese community. They were board members of the Tonghua Hospitals and founders of the Chinese Chamber of Commerce. Mr. Ho Kum Tong funded and organized the St. John's Ambulance Brigade in Hong Kong. King George V conferred upon him the Order of St. John of Jerusalem and Knight of Grace. He also founded Po Leung Kuk, Ko Yu Fong Public Dispensary and the Helena May Institute. He was interested in Chinese opera and often performed for charity events. Besides making generous donations to charity, he personally raised funds for those in need, such as victims of the Boxer Rebellion and flood in China, and typhoon and plague in Hong Kong. With his son-in-law, Mr. De Gabo, he organized a procession for the 25th Jubilee celebration of King George V. According to his grandson, Dick, he was sick on the day of the event, so the Jubilee Dragon came to perform for him outside Kom Tong Hall. Being an owner of racehorses, he was prominent among the racing circle. He was also an expert in many fields, including horticulture, photography, feng shui, and Chinese medicine. He was a connoisseur of Chinese antiquities. His famous collection was displayed in the Chinese Antique Room at Kom Tong Hall. There was even a walk-in safe in the basement to store the collection.
Of Kom Tong Hall.
The entrance and the winding staircase right up to the top. The French living room and the Chinese ceremonial room. And also the two little towers on the top of the building where we used to play when we were children. My father built Kom Tong Hall when he was around his 30s. Furnished by a decorator from England. All the curtains and all the china, all the silver were all imported from England. Even the window panes are cut glass from England. And the carpets were Persian carpets made of silk, specially made for Kom Tong Hall to fit the different rooms. Even the long winding staircase was carpeted with Persian carpets. With a brass rod to hold them in. Everything in Kom Tong Hall was specially designed and made for Kom Tong Hall. Down below, with the French room, the Chinese ceremonial room, a billet room, and upstairs with the Chinese black wood, grandma's room and grandpa's room on each end of the building. And there was a chandelier hanging from the ceiling right down to the landing. There's a Chinese altar, almost like a Chinese temple, that accommodated the ancestors' memorial
plaque.
Mm-hmm. And we used to play in there. The children used to have our meals in that room. And there's another card room where Grandma entertained friends to play mahjong every day. The veranda was so large that you could put about five Chinese round tables. I think at my wedding, we had a dinner party there, and all the tables were in the veranda of Kom Tong Hall. At the entrance, there are three mirrors. I think there's a Chinese superstition sort of to throw all the bad luck out, you know, there's the mirror they're facing, so that everything is thrown out as it comes at the entrance to the building. Also remember very well the long dining room where we have all our very enjoyable Christmas parties. It was very, very large. All the old relatives and all the grandchildren. And the cracker was so large that Grandma and Grandpa used to pull it about 6 feet apart. And we used to rush in and to collect all the prizes inside. And once I picked up a violin that was over a foot long. Imagine that inside the cracker.
How many people were there?
Oh, I should say about 50 people. And everyone had a different present. And Grandma used to buy them from Lynn Crawford's before the party began. We had the most delicious candies, all the nicest silver and china.
What is the menu for dinner?
We eat for dinner game pie made from pate de foie gras from France, and the chestnut pudding, which we all remember, and the crystal pudding with our special eggnog sauce. Father even prepared for his last days. He is the only person in Hong Kong with a private cemetery. And even his coffin he bought it himself. He picked the wood up from Liu Chao. And it was stored for many, many years. Even the Japanese didn't take them away, and they were eventually buried in coffins filled with the wood that he purchased from Liu Chao.
Here are some decorative objects that used to be in Kom Tong Hall. The Mormon Church bought Kom Tong Hall in 1959. The original furnishings are gone, but the church has done a tremendous job in maintaining and preserving the exterior and interior of this magnificent mansion. The stained glass windows, winding staircase, wood paneling, the white gilded living room, and wrought iron verandahs still look the way they did years ago. Kom Tong Hall is one of the few Western-style buildings of its era still in existence in Hong Kong. However, the disturbing news that it will be demolished was revealed recently. Due to appeal from the public, family members, and the Antiquities and Monument Office, the Hong Kong government has stepped in with a compensation offer and has successfully persuaded the Mormon Church to put the demolition on hold. Hopefully, the government will arrive at a permanent solution to preserve this historic mansion as part of Hong Kong's heritage from the past, and it will remain for the enjoyment of future generations.